So this is an introduction of consumer behavior, you might treat it as. And as I was telling you that we will be continuing our discussion on marketing. It is not that we are starting from here. We have already talked about marketing management. And when we were talking about marketing management, we have talked about the basics of marketing. And that basics of marketing, we will try to filter it down. And then we will now try to understand it minutely. And when we are talking consumer behavior, we will try to understand the psychological perspective of marketing, right? So this is what we will try to do. So before starting, let us first talk of what we have already done, because this is important where we are coming from. We have already talked about, so we will not spend much time on it. We know that we are coming from somewhere. We know that we had production orientation, which is also called as production concept. We know that we had sales concept. We know we had marketing concept and societal marketing concept, right? And now why is it important to understand is because the marketing has evolved over the period of time. How it has evolved is because when you would look at production orientation and sales orientation, then we were talking of marketers being the sole decider that this is what I will produce and this is what I will sell in the market. Now this thing has changed. Marketer is not the sole decider today. It is the consumer who is actually asked first, and the need of consumer is understood, and this need is then taken care of, and the products are floated into the market as a solution of those needs, right? So this is how the marketing has evolved over the period of time. Very, very important. And I think that the second part of it, which is this thing, unrecognized needs, if you would look here. Now, this is something which is very much important to understand here. And in fact, when we will talk of consumer behavior, we will be emphasizing a lot more on to unrecognized needs, because we have already talked about that unsatisfied needs were the basics of marketing. Now the marketing has carried over and now we are talking unrecognized needs. So we do understand the difference between these two, and we know that the unsatisfied needs are primarily the basic needs which are unsatisfied, like the need for food. Now we are going into unsatisfied to unrecognized needs. So unrecognized means what? Something the consumer was not aware of. It was told to him that you also have this need, and then the consumer was realizing, yes, this is actually a very important need and I need to have a solution to it, and hence he will look after the products which can actually satisfy this need, and that is how the marketing is going on. So now we are talking of unrecognized needs. So it is on the basis of this that we were talking about segmentation, targeting and positioning. Now how these two things are related, just a very quick connection between these things is that segmentation, targeting and positioning, which is fondly called as STP in marketing. Now these all are done on the basis of your needs, right? So now these needs can be unsatisfied or they can be unrecognized. So now the segmentation, targeting and positioning is being done on the basis of unrecognized needs, not onto unsatisfied needs only, because somewhere down the line we will talk in the times to come that unsatisfied needs in a basic sense have come towards maturity. So there is a lot of playing ground which is still left to be conquered when we are talking of unrecognized needs, right? Then we have to have the knowledge in our mind about marketing mix, and let us not confuse marketing mix with other mixes also which we talk in marketing, right? We talk of product mix also. So product mix is different from marketing mix. Marketing mix is basically a kind of mixture of all the marketing activities that we do. And I hope that you have gone through that paper also, the concept of marketing mix by Neil H. Borden, wherein the concept of marketing mix was introduced to the literature and how it has evolved to the point wherein we are talking of 4 P's. And I hope that you would also be remembering that now we are in fact moving away from the 4 P's and we are getting into the domain of 4 C's and 4 A's. In fact, people have started talking about further to that, and that we will discuss when we will be talking of specific topics in consumer behavior. So 4 P's only were product, price, place and promotion. Then when we were talking of the 4 P's, 2 4 C's and 2 4 A's shift, now this is how it actually was considered. So Lauterborn talk of 4 C's, and then Jagdish Seth talk of Four A's. So this is something how we have evolved in the marketing. So how is 4P different from 4C's, and how is 4C different from 4A's? The difference point is that as we are moving away from the 4P's and as we are approaching towards the 4A's, we are realizing that we are getting more customer centric. Right? This is the only difference, and that is something which is also depicted on the top of it. That production sales to marketing. So to 4P's we are going to 4A's. So marketing is more customer centric. So production and sales was not customer centric, as I was telling you a while ago. Then we also have seen the attempts of extending the marketing mix. We were talking about that even Kotler also proposed public opinion, political power. We were talking of the four P's extended to four, not four, seven P's in case of services. We also have a course of services in this semester. So you will also read it up, and then we will realize the importance of these additional three P's in the existing four P's model. So this is something that we should keep back in mind, that 4Ps were actually attempted, and that certain people who have actually suggested the addition of additional Ps, but then they were not seeing the light of the day as the 4Ps have get the acceptance of the people at large. Now with this background, let us try to get into the mind of consumer, and this is the course is about. Now this pictorial depiction speaks about two very closely related brands, Coke or Pepsi. So we might say that we or you or I prefer Coke, or you and I prefer Pepsi, but then why do we prefer Coke, why do we prefer Pepsi? If we talk of say chemical composition, yes, there might be some difference, and there can be some people who would actually be in a position to identify without having known the name of the brand that this is Coke and this is Pepsi, right? But they are still very closely related products. Now what in our mind decides that I should go for Coke or I should go for Pepsi? Now very closely related products, and this is something which sits in our mind, and we actually have to understand it. And that is where, when we are talking of so close calls, the two products which are so closely related, then that is where we have to talk of psychology of marketing, right? And you have to appreciate the fact that it is highly confusing. You do not understand your brain fully. We also do not understand our brains fully. We do not know that why at times we take certain decisions. It is so complex a structure. We do not know the answers to the questions which we are practicing, right? So this is something that actually is making this course so confusing. Adding to that, we have to appreciate the fact that we are having multiple selves. Multiple selves means what? You in classroom is a different individual than you in playground, right? You in classroom is a different individual than you in a party, in a birthday celebration of your friend. So multiple self, you as a student, you as a consumer, you as a player, you as a son, you as a daughter, you as whatnot. So you play different roles, and when you play different roles, then your decision, your choice also changes as per the role that you are currently in. We would also talk in the times to come that the specific role that you are playing at the current time would actually decide to a greater extent how do you accept the marketer's communication. To put the things in perspective, for example, if I am to advertise about a sports car, and I have various channels before me that I can go to, which channel should I choose for this advertisement of a sports car? Which channel should I choose? Are you getting my question? I have to advertise for a sports car, which is, kind of known for racing, which is not a regular product, which is a premium product. So which channel should I choose to advertise this product? Should I go with Star Plus? So why this is clear? No. And he says Star Sports, the sports channel, right? And maybe the time when Star Sports is actually broadcasting Formula One, in that it will make a lot of sense. it has been proven that when you are watching Formula One racing and then you are looking at an advertisement which is of a sports car, then the message which is given by the sports car company is imbibed better by your brain because you are in that time in that specific role, right? And that is why you will find that the certain products do not make sense at certain channels, right? Now, this product would definitely make no sense on Aastha. You can do that. Nobody stops you. Aastha will make money. If you go to them and if you say that I would like to advertise this product on your channel, Aastha would say happily agreed. But then, will it influence the consumers? You are not at all having your target audience on Aastha, right? So that does not make sense. And that is why, and it is not kind of, you can also watch Aastha. ऐसा नहीं है कि आप आस्था नहीं देखेंगे. आप भी आस्था देख सकते हैं, ठीक है? और देखते भी हैं. आपकी एज के काफी लोग आस्था देखते भी हैं. प्रॉब्लम क्या है कि जब आस्था आप देख रहे हैं उस समय आप एक अलग रोल में हैं और उसका प्रभाव पड़ता है कि किस तरह से आप किसी चीज को इम्बाइब करेंगे, किसी मैसेज को कैसे इम्बाइब करेंगे. चला गया? डबल टू डबल सिक्स प्राइमरीली जब हम अभी ये डिस्कशन कर रहे थे उसका दूसरे शब्दों में मतलब यही है कि प्रभाव पड़ता है. अगर आपको मैं एक एकेडमिक डिस्कशन से रिलेटेड किसी प्रोडक्ट की बात करूं तो वो क्लासरूम में करूंगा तो आपके ऊपर ज़्यादा प्रभाव पड़ेगा. इन कंपैरिजन टू आप खेल रहे हैं, आपकी टीम खेल रही है, आप साइड में बैठे हैं, आप अपनी टीम को देख रहे हैं, आपकी बैटिंग का नंबर है, आप आउट होकर आराम से बैठ गए, मैं आपके पास जाऊँ कितना बढ़िया किताब आई है नहीं अच्छा होगा, तो वो प्रभाव उतना नहीं डालेगी आपके ऊपर जितना आप इस सेटिंग में कितने हो. इनफैक्ट इसको आप इस तरह से भी रिलेट करने की कोशिश करो, जैसे शायद मैंने आपको कभी बताया भी हो कि इंडिया में टेलीविजन्स कहाँ रखे जाते हैं. इंडिया एज अ कंट्री वी आर फॉलोइंग अ स्पेसिफिक कल्चर, हम एक कल्चर को फॉलो करते हैं, ठीक है ना? हम उस देश से आते हैं जिस देश में जब आप गाड़ी लेके निकलते हो तो गाड़ी के टायर के ऊपर पानी फेंकना होता है, ठीक है ना जी? हमें कहते हैं ना कि वी आर कंट्री ऑफ स्नेक चार्मर्स, ठीक है जी? हम रिलीजन में इतना ज़्यादा विश्वास रखते हैं. तो हमारे जैसे देश के अंदर टीवी कहाँ रखा जाएगा? ड्राइंग रूम में रखा जाएगा, ठीक है जी? अच्छा, क्या आपको लगता है कि अगर टीवी ड्राइंग रूम में रखा है तो उसका प्रभाव अलग होगा, अगर वो बेडरूम में रखा है तो उसका प्रभाव अलग होगा? आर यू गेटिंग माय क्वेश्चन?
अगर वो डाइनिंग टेबल वाले डाइनिंग रूम में रखा है तो पता है आपको ऐसे रिसर्चेस आर गोइंग ऑन एट दिस लेवल
दैट इंडिया एज अ कंट्री, एक बहुत ही ब्रॉड मैक्रो लेवल की बात है ये, एक माइक्रो लेवल की बात नहीं, मैक्रो का मतलब पूरा देश, इस देश का एज ए कल्चर अगर टेलीविजन को डाइनिंग रूम में या फिर ड्राइंग रूम में रखना पसंद करता है तो यहाँ पर किस तरह का कम्युनिकेशन बेहतर रहेगा, किस तरह की कम्युनिकेशन स्ट्रेटजी इंडिया में अपनाई जानी चाहिए? जस्ट टू गिव यू एन आइडिया कि आप सीएट टायर्स के एड जो है ना देख लो भारत के अंदर, और सीएट टायर्स वही कंपनी, उसी के एड इफ यू वुड लुक एट द सेम प्रोडक्ट इन यूएसए यू विल फाइंड देयर इज लॉट ऑफ डिफरेंस द वे दे कम्युनिकेट टू द पीपल. प्रोडक्ट इज सेम, व्हाई? बिकॉज वी आर डिफरेंट पीपल, वी आर डिफरेंट कल्चर, वी टेक द मैसेजेस इन अ डिफरेंट वे, एंड दैट इज समथिंग विच रिलेट्स टू आवर मल्टीपल सेल्फ ऑल्सो, राइट? एंड दैट इज समथिंग दैट वी विल डू व्हेन वी विल टॉक ऑफ कल्चर इन दैट ग्रुप डायनेमिक्स, देन वी विल रियलाइज दैट हाउ इम्पोर्टेंट इज कल्चर फॉर अस एंड टू वट एक्सटेंट आर वी डीपली एम्बेडेड इन टू अवर कल्चर. वी डो नॉट रियलाइज दिस, वी आर एब्सोल्यूटली डीपली यू नो एम्बेड इन टू अवर कल्चर्स एंड वी आर नथिंग बट योर रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ आवर कल्चर्स. आवर पर्सनैलिटी इज नथिंग बट इज रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ आवर कल्चर्स ओनली, राइट? सो दिस इज समथिंग दैट वी विल डू. Now, to understand this brain is always a challenge. That will always be a challenge. And that has never been attempted with 100% surety. And that will never be attempted with 100% surety. But still, this course helps us in committing the errors to a level which is little less than that we would do if we would not consider the psychological concepts. Right? So, this is the idea behind this. Now marketing is confusing. Now just to put the things in perspective, that how psychology is important. Now look at this product which has come up. Now can you see the date here? This is 5th of August 2018. It is as recent as 5th August. A brand is launched which is a swimwear that should not be worn in water. Are you getting it? A swimsuit which should not be worn in water or in a swimming pool. And people are liking it, right? Which part of your brain is telling you to purchase this? I mean, where is the logic? What is the utility of this product, right? Now look at this, and this is not the only thing. There are a lot of brands also which you will find that they are actually confusing me like anything. Now this is written: do not get wet or immerse in water. This is suitable only for sunbathing. And people are saying that they have created a new market. Created a new market in the sense, one is swimsuit which you can use in swimming pool. One is swimsuit which you should not use in swimming pool. You should only use for the sun bath when you are on beach. That's it. When you are getting into the water, no, that is not meant for that. No, that is not. A new market has evolved. Altogether new market. Now, which side of your brain and which psychology and which concept is telling you to do that and to make such products to see the light of the day, right? Now that is why the psychology of consumer is so, that is where the unrecognized needs is coming into picture. Now would you have ever imagined that a product of this sort would also come? The marketer is telling you, no, the swimsuit is different, now you should also have something else, and a new market has come up, right? Unrecognized needs. Have you ever thought that PVR and Enox are making a larger portion of their profit from the foods and drinks that they sell, not the movies for which they are made? Are you getting the point? Now, what make you to drink a Coke or Pepsi when you are watching a movie? Will the show stop if you don't purchase a Coke or Pepsi? Will the roll stops rolling? Will Salman Khan stop here? Coke नहीं है, आगे नहीं चलेगा. It is you who are taking this decision कि let's have Coke, let's have Pepsi. And when you will read out, you will realize that PVR is actually, you know, getting 30% of their total quarterly revenue from the foods and beverages only. I mean, this is huge. Of 684 crores that they are talking of, now 30% of it is Pepsi, burger, sandwich, and that big tub of popcorn. This is what they are getting their money from. And you feel happy about eating it. It has no connection with the entertainment value that you will receive out of that movie. Popcorn doesn't increase it. Coke doesn't increase it, but it is here. We will discuss it in some of the topics which we will do in coming times. From where this habit would have come? This habit of drinking, this habit of eating something when you are watching a movie, where it would have come? When would be the first time that someone would have used and someone would have thought of movie watching, Coke and Pepsi? It has come from somewhere. It has not been dropped from the sun. It has come from someone has started it. And it is not, this someone is not you and I, this someone is marketer somewhere. He has actually taught you to do this. Right, and we will discuss it in the times to come. Right, so marketer has taught you unrecognized need. It tastes better. Now, do you remember those ads wherein it says World Cup tastes better with thumbs up? It makes sense. Okay, thumbs up. So this is what this is. They are teaching you, and this is your psychology. And there are times when you don't feel like doing all this. I do not know whether you have also come across this. It is said, I do not know it is a hoax or rumor, I mean people are talking, it is making a lot of rounds on social media also nowadays, that the Amul has won a lawsuit against Quality Walls and a lot of other ice cream manufacturers. And if this story is to be believed, then in future no brand other than Amul can use the name ice cream on their ice creams. Now the name which is given to the product is Frozen Desserts. Ice cream is only or can only be used by Amul. And the reason is that the frozen dessert is a name given to an ice cream, for that matter, which is made from vegetable oils, which in Hindi we call as dalda. The ghee made ice cream is actually an ice cream. And so the Amul have filed a lawsuit that they cannot use ice cream as a word to their products, because ice cream, they are using vegetable oils, highly saturated vegetable oils, and that at the max is dalda, and hence they should be called as the frozen desserts. And the court has also said, as per this news, that no, only Amul can use the word ice cream. So this is something that you will find written on the back of your ice cream packs. If this is true, frozen desserts contain edible vegetable oils, not ice cream. They should not use it, right? And you can read it also. This is the continuation of this story. If you can read this thing, this is written here very clearly in the story thing. Amul has won a lawsuit against Walls, Quality and some other branded ice creams. They can no longer sell their products as ice creams. Hence, the new marketing name is Frozen Desserts. If you check labels of items sold as frozen dessert, it does say hydrogenated vegetable oils, which is dalda. Right? So this is something which is happening. Now, will it impact the purchase of consumers? This is the question. Will you, from today onwards, when you know this, will you only be asking for Amul, or you are okay with still Quality Walls or Mother Dairy or anything, Body Lals, whatever comes your way? Would you ask for Amul or not? Now, why is this so? Because you look at the perspective of Quality Walls or Body Lals or Mother Dairy, they would say ki the product that we are selling is in no way damaging, to no way creating problems. But psychology ke andar wo hamari cheez hai. Ho sakta hai aap uske liye zyada paise bhi denge agar wo aapka shuddh usse bana hua hai to. So this is how the psychology is actually playing a role.